We started our day by heading to Nwanetse picnic site for an outdoor breakfast. We bumped into this mating pair again. They were at the same spot as they were a few days earlier. All the other cars just passed by. Nobody really wanted to disturb them, and neither did we. So we just took a few photos and continued to Nwanetse. Hello everybody, I'm Karabo, your Northern Bushman. Please subscribe to our channel. Before starting with breakfast preps, we first went uphill to the lookout point, and it was refreshing. We then started with our breakfast preps, and later we would go to Swenyahyde before the long trip to Chokwani and back. The feeling you get when visiting hides cannot be explained. At first, all you see is a body of water and trees, but when you take a closer look, you'll see its beauty. Thank you. We headed back towards Satara via the S100. We still hadn't decided on the route to use to get to Chokwane, so we just told ourselves that we'll cross that bridge when we get to Satara. The time now is 11 o'clock, so but we want to be back this side at least by 1500, 3 o'clock. So, yeah, so basically we are here. We're going to go all the way down until we reach Chokwane. And that's where we're going to have our lunch, yeah, because we miss those buffalo pies and chips. And then go back all the way up to Satara. Should be doable. We've never done this route before, but yeah, hopefully
if it gets hectic we can always take this one.
Yeah, I was about to say if it gets hectic and then we're like, oh no, we can always go here and then go back up again.
Yeah,
or if we see cars coming from the east going west and then we're here, usually we would wait for a car here and ask these guys what they saw here. Was there a leopard on a tree? Were there lions or something interesting? Were there wild dogs? Or was there good sighting of elephants or just wildlife scenery in general? Because as you can see, there's water holes and pans all over because there's a river flowing here. So we wait here, we ask them. If they say they saw nothing, we continue. We wait here. If they say they saw nothing and we still feel like we've got the energy to go down and the time allows, most importantly, we still continue, come back here. And then from here to here is roughly 45, 49, between 43 to 49 kilos. So that's like 2 hour drive. So the way it's looking, time might not be on our side. So I'm thinking we're going to just come out here, but we'll see. We'll let you know. Cheers. While on our way to Chokwane, we came across a mating pair of white-headed vultures. For us, this was a first. At this point, we had decided to take a shortcut back to Satara, but the crew had other ideas. These elephants blocked us, and we were forced to reroute further south to Chokwane. But this wasn't a big deal for us. We know that everything in Kruger happens for a reason, so we were looking forward to what the bush had to offer. In Chokwani, we just visited the Loo. We didn't spend much time there. And after leaving Chokwani, we were soon thanking those elephants for blocking us. Because now we came across a leopard that had just killed a porcupine. The leopard got his nutritional snack, but that came at a cost. He had two quills stuck under his jaw that he could not remove. The drive back to camp was a sad one. We kept thinking about the leopard we had seen, but that's just the way of nature, I suppose. On day 5, our first sighting of the day was of the bush troops, followed by an amazing herd of elephants. Minutes just before gate closure, we were lucky enough to see Caspar and one of his brothers again. On day 6, we left camp around 2 o'clock in the afternoon. It was still so hot, so the plan was to drive back slowly to camp as the sun sets. We were about 2 kilometers from Satara, already had started thinking about our dinner preps, when out of nowhere came this male leopard. And as if this leopard sighting wasn't enough to close the day, just about 200 meters on, there was another leopard on a tree. This was our last night in Satara. We had packed up our camping equipment earlier in the morning because we didn't want to waste any time the next day. The only thing to do now was to make some pap, relish, vors, and short ribs. On day 7, the day of departure, we didn't see much for the first 30 to 35 kilometers until this magnificent male lion. We passed by Chokwani and did the usual, the loo, and pulled out some ice cream from the fridge. We were now anxious because for the first time in years, we were going to leave the Kruger without completing the Big Five, but the Kruger wasn't ready to disappoint us just yet. You know, when you're not desperate for sightings, they just come to you. From a distance, we saw this pride of lions. Though we didn't see the kill, but they looked like their bellies were full. Just when we thought our luck had run out, then we had one of the best sightings of this trip, wild dogs. The Kruger has a habit of tormenting us with beautiful sightings right at the very end, as if it's asking us, why are you leaving? I would like to thank everybody that watches our videos, and if you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe. It motivates us to do more videos like this. This is goodbye for now. Stay safe.